We're here at the Ericsson stand at Mobile World Congress Los Angeles. I'm with Tomas from Ericsson, and we're going to be talking about 5G, in particular the 5G core. So what are some of the questions or challenges that customers are having related to the 5G core in the North American market?
Well, I think it's similar to other markets. It's just that so much is happening here in the North American market.
Sure.
It's all about automation. And why is that so important? It's for several reasons, right? I think first of all, we're going into cloud-native software, and with that we really have to have a flawless execution of a software delivery automation to manage this from a lifecycle management point of view. And that, in order to make that work, it needs automation. The second is that, you know, we're also going to start shifting workloads and scale in and out the size of the application, depending on the needs and where the application sits, in the edge or in this core. And all that needs to be done in real time, and that can also only be done with automation. And I think third and the most important reason is that our customers really are excited about finding new revenues with 5G and 5G core. And that means also that in order to make it work with all this kind of, you know, quite big complexity, right? I mean, we also have to find automation in that, not only to kind of set up the service, but actually to let their clients, specifically enterprise clients, also do a lot of self-service so that, you know, we take away a lot of the cost and promote speed.
Okay, so you outlined a few issues there. Now, how is Ericsson sort of diving in and helping operators to address these issues?
Very good. First of all, I think the way we design our cloud-native software, we also bring the application development platform logic that sits under all our different cloud-native software, which means that we are making use of a platform where we have a lot of common components, so we are reusing them for performance, fault management, database logic, etc., and so on, so that it's easy to maintain this software and do updates and upgrades in small instances when we need to. Kind of microservices logic, and we can do it also in service. I think that's another way we can help operators. So that meaning that they don't have to have maintenance windows and it can do it while things are running. And you can see some of the great demos here. We show this live actually here. The other thing we're doing is that we are also having a lot of software that really fits together and to make this work end to end. From a core, you need orchestration software that handles all the resource management and transport management as well as service orchestration. And we have invested in that portfolio, so we help our operators because we really can make all these things play together.
Yeah, now let's talk about what that looks like. Maybe tell me a little bit about the virtual innovation center for 5G.
Yes, so we have invested a lot here to make sure that we are ready for our customers when they're going to go 5G. And we have now launched a virtual innovation center here in the US and to really be close to our customers and really to make sure that we can help them from a use case perspective to validate and also to harden, so to speak, the solution that needs to work across all these software components and also on their infrastructure that they have selected to have. So we really make sure to prove that for our customers here. And that requires a lot of competence on infrastructure, on orchestration, on core, even on devices and assurance, where we have all these skills. And that's what we're ramping up to be ready for our customers here.
Okay, fantastic. So how does, one of the changes with 5G is sort of, as you outlined, is sort of the way that people are bringing technology to market. One of those ways is, you know, cloud native, and companies are becoming cloud native, service providers are becoming cloud native. Does that allow operators to bring new services and new capabilities to market faster?
Absolutely, and I think the beauty as well of what we are doing when it comes to this space is that we are really working with our software to be not only compliant to the 3GPP standard, but also working with all the key open source forums here, like CNCF and other ones, and using a lot of the open source so that it's easy for the ecosystem to start contributing as well in this system. So I think when we have also this application development platform, where we have a lot of the kind of necessary common functions, it's going to be quite easy to ingest innovation and different microservices into this system of software that we have. I think that's how we're going to facilitate that.
So why is Ericsson in the best possible position to help its customers with these concerns that they have with, you know, related to the 5G core?
I think the most important thing is that to really make it work, you also have to have competence what really means to make it work end to end. And I think we are market leader with 5G on radio. We have 49 markets launched in the US with all operators, all four operators here in 22 states. No one is close to that. We are, for example, even from device point of view, we are testing more than half of all the 5G available devices we are testing as a service to all these device providers. And then we have our position in packet core, which is also we're leading globally, and also investing a lot in the software and orchestration. So I think with the R&D muscle we have and the competence we have to really make this work end to end, I think that we are in a much better position to help our customers to launch new services.
Okay, Tomas, thanks so much for speaking with us today. I really appreciate it.